My name is Elisabetta Giuffra. I work at INRAE. First, I would like to thank the organizers for this session. I will give this introductory talk, Functional Annotation of Animal Genomes, the European Perspective. The process of annotating genomes can be exemplified by Google Map views. Compared to the left, the right panel contains specific indications to find places, such as roads, squares, and parks. Building reference annotation maps of genomes implies to identify and characterize the structures of genes and other functional, non-coding, regulatory elements. Annotating genomes is a fundamental requisite in order to decipher the genotype to phenotype or genome to phenome link. And this is at the heart of predictive biology, that means using genomic information to predict complex phenotypic outcomes. In the past 20 years, studies in humans and model organisms provided key knowledge on this area. We know that less than 2% of the genome code for proteins, that non-coding regions harbor a rich array of functionally significant elements with diverse gene regulatory and other functions, and importantly, that the genetic variants affecting disease and other complex traits are found enriched in regulatory non-coding regions of genomes. And the work of this consortia has underlined how improved functional annotations is most efficiently delivered collaboratively. Reference annotation maps of genomes are built by identifying which bits of genome are functional at different times, different physiological conditions, and using different tissues, cell populations, and single cells, and so on. And the assays by sequencing developed by ENCODE and other consortia are continuously evolving. They target, in fact, different levels of genome complexity. If you look at the figure from the right, the assays can be used to characterize gene expression, and then going to the left, chromatin modifications like histones, chromatin accessibility, and chromatin 3D conformation. And the integration of all these assays put together what is a reference genome map. In the circles, I underlined the assays that are already in use since some years by the animal genomics community. The goals for annotating the genomes of farmed animals are aimed to fundamental sciences, that means supporting fundamental animal sciences to link cell, tissue, and whole animal scale knowledge, for example, dissecting emerging complex phenotypes and genotype-environment interactions, and providing information to accelerate the genomic improvement, and especially in the context of genomic selection. Linking the trait-associated SNPs with function at better SNP location can be interesting for identifying, of course, causal variants, but also to reduce the search space for causative variation and improve cross-population accuracy. I put here two examples from the bovine genomics community. At the left, SNPs in candidate bovine enhancer regions marked by specific histone modifications were found enriched for association with milk production traits. While more recently at the right, functional regions of a genome were specifically studied by assaying histone modification and one transcription factor in six tissues, and this led to identify the enrichment of putative causal variants in these regions in lactating dairy cows. FAANG is a coordinated international action to accelerate genome-to-phenome research. Since 2015, with the first white paper that you see on the bottom, it is a global collaboration that provides high quality, wants to provide high quality functional annotation of animal genomes with a focus on the livestock and aquaculture community. Core aims are achieve data openness in the communities, reusability, rich metadata, and standardization. It aims to support the community and bring in researchers from different funded projects to coordinate efforts to create a harmonized and rich genome-to-phenome G2P or G2P resource. The Global Fund collaboration can be seen as a network of geographical communities. And these communities are individually made of institutes with a long-term track of collaborations in animal sciences before joining FAANG. And both the US and UA communities are extremely representative in FAANG and include also partners who pioneered the FAANG action. EuroFAANG is a recent coordinated effort to harmonize FAANG research in Europe. It aims to create free resources that link genotype to phenotype to improve animal production and welfare. The effective kickoff was back in February 2020, just days before the lockdown of the pandemic, during a multi-day workshop hosted by MBLEBI in Ingston. EuroFAANG has been initiated by three founder projects: AquaFAANG, Bobreg, and GeneSwitch. You see some details in the pictures and text. And to build this project, we replied to a topic called SFS30, aimed to understanding the genome of farmed animals, its expression and translation into traits. The project spanned 4 years. I'm not providing detailed outlines of what each project does. I prefer to provide the common features they have. First, they have core activities of functional annotations in fish species, in bovine, in chicken and pigs. And all of them include work packages aiming at using the improved annotation for scope-oriented research, for example, for improving models for genomic selections. They also co-developed together with European industry and or associations and organizations, mostly as full partners, in a real process of co-creation. And they all include consistent efforts for dissemination, training, and networking activities. The main goals of EuroFAANG are for collaborative scientific developments, particularly for analysis pipelines and shared standards for annotating genomes, for strategies for comparative analysis across projects, for using annotations in genomic prediction. It aims to also implement organize shared training to courses, and to implement joint dissemination and outreach activities. Overall, we expect that this should add considerable value to European research within the Global Fund collaboration. For collaborative scientific developments, we are working groups. We're already meeting regularly since early 2020. One is for pipeline development and standards and validation. It is chaired by Cedric Notre Dame from the Bovreg Consortium. And I underline that a workshop was held in November 2020 by the Bovreg Consortium for training and adoption of pipelines under the NFCore NextFlow platform. Another group, the Comparative Analysis Group, is chaired by Daniel McQueen and Hendrik Jan Megens from AquaFAANG. It is aiming to facilitate comparison of data sets across projects, implement future plans, and of course, helping the cross-project publication strategy. Finally, we have also a group, although it is as a working group, it is in progress, but let's say that meetings already are held and there is collaboration between projects for approaches for using genome annotations in genomic prediction. For shared training courses, we aim at the harmonization of training plans of the three individual projects. These courses are already opened up to all EuroFAANG members and to the wider, and they will open to the wider FAANG communities where possible. The table just shows the organization in progress actually for 2022-2023. And of course, it will depend a lot on the COVID pandemics and how it will evolve. The EuroFAANG Dissemination and Outreach Working Group has as a main aim to maximize the stakeholders' engagement and uptake of results by targeting a wide range of stakeholder groups. And indeed, several activities have been implemented since 2020, including this meeting. And in the figure, you see how individual specific institutes from the three projects are involved to carry out work for the dissemination and outreach. For coordination on the basis of a shared roadmap of development, there are regular meetings held between the three projects that are chaired by Peter Harrison and Paul Flicek for Data Coordination Center of FAANG and Ensemble at MBLEBI. It's the lieu for high-level agreements and decisions on cross-project coordination, dissemination, training, and comparative analysis to agree on shared developments of the FAANG Data Coordination Center jointly with Ensemble, and on joint statements and conference presentations of EuroFAANG with strong support of the EuroFAANG Communication Outreach Working Group. And here we oversee the output of working groups, training and dissemination activities. We hope that new projects that started this year in 2021 will join soon EuroFAANG. These two projects in particular answer topic call SFS14 for genome and epigenome enabled breeding in terrestrial livestock. Geronimo is coordinated by Frederick Pittel. It targets both chicken and pigs for cosmopolitan and local breeds. Second one, Rumigen, is coordinated by Eric Payou, as well from INRAE, and it targets cattle with a specific interest in animal health and welfare traits. What are today the new FAANG goals and priorities for farmed animal breeding? The idea is to layer the functional maps, obtained typically from few individuals, into different genotypes in informative populations. The process implies the use of powerful tools for predictive biology to understand the biological processes driving phenotypes and to take into account really the current scenarios of animal productions, including societal, ethical and environmental constraints on breeding and husbandry. The goal is to contribute to develop new paradigms for applied genomics to tackle challenges in animal productions, based on new drivers for breeding and management. In the recent white paper of the FAANG Consortium, published in late 2020, some priorities have been outlined in order to achieve these goals. I'm not going into details for limiting time. What about the perspectives of EuroFAANG? I think that first, we should really work to increase its critical mass with a new project to join. And we should further reinforce the role of a FAANG data portal to host and harmonize the results from these projects. We should keep putting adequate resources to both research, communication outreach, and training for both academia and the industry. We should strengthen the connection with other existing EU communities, for example, for the fast adoption of emerging genomic technologies developed in biotechnology research, and also to grasp the new research opportunities between by the crossing of different fields that maybe are not evident by now. And we should harmonize the efforts in all this with other EU initiatives that are aiming also from different angles to the same broad goals in a spirit of cooperation and fair competition. Finally, I will mention that there is an infrastructure project being built with the coordination of Emily Clark, that will be probably prepared for 2022, that is aimed to ensure adequate governance, resources and durability to such goals that were exposed today. I thank you a lot for your attention. I will stop here.